This tutorial shows you how to use the newest masks in Lightroom and Camera Raw, and that is the landscape masks. And if you want to dig in deep and really learn masks in Lightroom and Camera Raw, check out my course. It's called Masks in Lightroom and Camera Raw. And it's 3 hours of training that teaches you everything you need to know about using these masks in depth. And I'll give you a discount. I'll put that in the link. So anyway, check out the tutorial. All right, let's have a look at the newest type of mask, and that is the landscape mask. So why don't we start with this particular image here, and we're going to go to the develop module. Of course, we're going to go to the masks in the masks panel, and you'll see landscape. So if we tap on landscape, what it's going to do is it's going to detect different features in here, very much the same as it does with people. You know, where it detects the eyes, the lips, etc. Except this time, it detects different features in the landscape. Now, of course, it could be artificial ground, there's buildings, there's water, there's other options, but obviously those are not in this picture. So it's going to show what it sees in the picture. So what we're going to do is we're going to grab the sky, the mountains. Now, sometimes notice the vegetation here as I roll over it. By the way, you can see it. Notice it gets the entire ground, except for the fence, which is really good. So we're going to select that. But notice if we go to the natural ground, see how we get a little bit of overlap there? And sometimes you're going to see that between different masks, you're going to see a little bit of overlap. Because when I choose the natural ground, it's going to choose the rocks as well as the grass. So to be honest, that mask is not really going to be that useful to us because we've got the mountains are choosing the rocks, vegetation is picking the ground. And of course, we can add or take away from the masks if we want to, you know, kind of change the grass or whatever. All right, so we're going to create three separate masks and then choose create mask. Now you'll notice that they appear in the masks panel. And so why don't we start with the mountains, because these are quite difficult. You know, of course we can turn the overlay off, but if you look at these, we're losing a lot of detail there. And this is because the sun is kind of setting and it's hitting and, you know, it's kind of cool, but let's make it look a little bit better. So if we choose the overlay, it will show the area, but as soon as we move some of the sliders, it will get rid of it. So to bring back the detail in a situation like this, what we want to do is pump up the blacks a little bit. Notice as we do that, it starts to bring out a little bit more of that detail. Now notice though, if we hit the backslash key for before and after, it's also increasing the saturation. So this means that we can take our saturation and pull this back a little bit. And this is also helping with the readability, because what was happening with the saturation was starting to clip a little bit in those rocks. All right, so let's go down and we're going to go here. And by the way, saturation clipping in the rocks means that the color is becoming so strong that it's losing detail there because the monitor isn't able to display the detail with that amount of color. All right, so let's go down, and what we're going to do this time is under the effects, we're going to give it a little bit of texture. And as we increase this texture, see how we can just really chisel out those rocks. So if we want to look at the legibility, if we look at these before and after, notice we've brought a lot more legibility to these rocks. We could even light them a little bit if we wanted to keep a little bit more like the original. So if we take the exposure and just give it a little touch, we could do that. In this case, I don't think we need to give it a ton. Now, notice that this hole in the rock is actually really there. But if we go to the sky there, I notice that the sky is also very saturated. So we could go to the saturation and we could reduce the saturation just a little bit in the sky so it looks a little less cartoony. Now, of course, this is all up to you how you want to do it. I'm going to take the highlights. I'm going to pull those back a little bit. And that's just going to kind of give me a little bit more in the clouds and maybe pop open the shadows. Even though it's not going to be doing a lot, it's just kind of making that sky look a little less cartoony. And we're kind of getting this because I was using a polarizer, you know, which we want to use for the blue sky, but just be careful sometimes. All right, so let's go down to the vegetation and we can brighten this area up here if we like. So if we can take the exposure and we can just open that up, or we could take the shadows and open up the shadows instead. Maybe give it a little touch of exposure. All right, that's looking pretty good for the foliage. Now, if you didn't want that grass here, we can go in and we can modify this mask, of course. Under vegetation here, we can choose subtract, and we can grab a brush. Now notice the brush shows minus. That means it's going to subtract from what we're painting. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to increase the brush size by just hitting the right bracket key a couple of times. And the reason I do that, rather than using the slider, as I've mentioned on this course already, is if you change the size here, you can't see it on the image. In this case, we can. And then what I'm going to do, though, is I'm going to take the density down a little bit, and I'm also going to take the flow down a little bit. The reason I'm doing that is because then I'm not going to completely remove the mask from the grass. I'm just going to reduce it, which means that the trees are going to get more of the adjustment than the grass is, but the grass is still going to get a little bit. All right, and because the fence wasn't selected in the first place, we can just go over there. It doesn't really matter. We don't have to be careful in that area, and I'm just going to just mask that out pretty quickly. Great. Now, if we look at the before and after, once again, backslash key, you can see, yeah, the grass is still being affected, but not as much as the trees now. And that enables me to maybe just brighten it up a little bit more if I like. And now we're not going to over brighten the grass. So if we look at this before and we look at it after, we can see we're able to use those landscape masks quite nicely. And then, of course, you know, at this point, if you want to do any adjustments, you know, overall adjustments to brightness or color temperature, saturation, anything like that, what we're going to do is go up to the top option here. And now we're just doing the general adjustment. Notice it will affect the entire image now and not just the masks. So if you wanted to do more, you know, fine tuning, maybe you wanted to warm it up a little bit or do different things, we can do that now. And it, you know, is doing overall. So I don't recommend doing things like color temperature stuff in local areas unless there's some kind of a color pollution, you know, some kind of a light pollution going on with different, you know, types of lighting. So unless you're going for an effect, be very careful when you do things like, you know, temperature and saturation. Try to do it across the board. In this situation, we're able to do saturation separately for the rocks there because that's, you know, giving us a specific thing we were targeting. All right, let's move on to another image. And here's another image here. And this one was in Hawaii. So what I'm going to do is we're going to do the same thing. We're going to go in there and we're going to choose landscape. And then it's going to see the features. This time you'll notice that there's natural ground, there's vegetation, architecture, and sky. So yes, it will pick up things like buildings and different things like that. So we are going to do the sky and we're going to do the architecture. Let's look at the vegetation. Notice with the vegetation, we're going to have a little bit of overlap. If you look where it is in the ground, and around the edge of the building, and then we look at the natural ground, once again, that overlap is there. So if I wanted to specifically adjust the ground, and I wasn't worried about the trees, I would turn on the natural ground, and I would use that. Now, if I wanted to do the trees, I would turn on the vegetation. So we're going to choose all of these, and we're going to create the mask. All right. So why don't we start with our architecture, with our building? So I'm going to choose the architecture here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to open up the shadows. Because what we're trying to do is see a little bit more of the detail there. Because notice it's just all in shadow. We can't really see what's really going on in that building. And I might give it a little pop of exposure too. Not much, just a tiny little touch. Generally, when I do these, I try to make the local adjustments, you know, things like shadow highlight and things like that. Okay, that's looking pretty good. And if we look at this before, after, notice we're popping a lot more detail there in that building. In fact, I'm just going to put the exposure back to where it was. So we're not even going to adjust that exposure. And we're just opening up the shadows there. Now, I could have done it in the whole image, but then it might have opened up a little too much here in the ground and in the trees in different parts. Let me just move that mask over here, get it out of the way. All right, that's looking pretty good. So let's have a look. Let's do the sky. So the sky is going to be tricky because notice we've got a little bit of bleeding, a little bit of overlap. If you were worried about it bleeding into the trees, you know, we could choose subtract. We could grab the brush. And then what we want to do is make sure we're on auto mask. And we want to turn all of this up. Drop the size down a little bit. And then using that auto mask, we could definitely remove that from those tree trunks. See that? You know, we could very easily do that. and that auto mask is going to help isolate that. I'm going to hope in time, and I'm sure in time, Adobe's going to improve this, because the masking is okay. The landscape masking, as you can see, it's far from perfect, so you know, you might have to do a little manual modification in here and there. But I just wanted to show you how that works. Okay, so let's go ahead and we're going to make that adjustment now. So what we're going to do is we are going to click back on the sky mask. And now we're going to go down to the adjustments. So let's take the highlights. We're going to pull those all the way back. And what we're doing, notice as we do this, it starts to show a little bit of those edges. Let me show you where my cursor is up here. See if things were kind of blooming a little bit. And we're going to bring back some of those edges a little bit. Now, it might look artificial right now, but that's okay. We'll make another adjustment in a moment. We'll help. Now, I can't bring back the color in the sky because it's just not there. It's blown out in the image. So, you know, maybe using a camera for high dynamic range, or you were bracketing to try and get that sky, you could. I could kind of maybe try to fake it by, you know, hitting some temperature and some different things here, like maybe pushing the exposure down. But let's not do that. I don't think it's going to look natural. All right, so we brought that back and we're seeing kind of a little bit more of the edges of that canopy. But now we need to go to the sky, which we're in here. But sorry, let's go to the vegetation now. And notice something here is going to be kind of interesting. So as I go into the highlights, notice as I bring the highlights back, see how that also helps the edges. And so we're starting to get a little bit more natural there, you know, so that's counteracting some of the artificial edges we were getting from the sun. So that's kind of helping a little bit. Let's open up our shadows just a little bit there and our foliage. And let's go here. And, you know, if you wanted, you could play around with temperature and saturation. I'm going to give it just a touch of saturation because I want that foliage to just pop a little bit. Okay, great. Now let's go to the ground. So if we choose the natural ground, I don't want the ground to be the important part of this photo. So we're going to take the highlight. We're going to pull it back a little bit. And then I'm even going to take the exposure and just drop it down. And notice what we're doing is we're just kind of de-emphasizing the ground a little bit. And we want to put our focus here on the building and this. So maybe go to the blacks and maybe we'll push the blacks a little bit more too, just to give it, there we go. And see what's happening? So now we're not getting competing tones here with this and the building. It's making the building more prominent without it making it look, at you know, artificial. So let's have a look. If we hit the left bracket key, we can see before and after. And see that? We've made quite a big difference to this particular image. Notice I'm not going super heavy-handed on this. I am trying to keep it a very kind of a natural adjustment. Of course, you can go as heavy-handed as you want. You know, if you're looking for different types of effects or different things like that, you could do that. Now, I feel like I want to just overall warm everything up. So once again, let's click on the adjustments here, go to the color temperature, and just move it up a little bit on the entire image. And notice how that just warms everything up quite nicely. So let's look at it once again, before, after. All right, so you can see the landscape masks can be used for, you know, landscape photos, but they can also be used for, you know, different types of photos that work with different features as well. And so if you want to learn more about masks, there's two things you can do. The first one is check out my course, Masks in Lightroom and Camera Raw. The other thing is check out this other video that I put there for you guys. Check that out. And also drop me a comment. Let me know if you found this video useful. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. I really encourage you to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my valuable tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.